Consumer Reports is busy testing the Apple iPhone X. Our secret shoppers bought them early Friday morning because we pay for all the items we test, which means our labs test the same phones you buy. The new iPhone X comes in two colors and two storage options, space gray and silver, and 64 and 256 gigabytes. Apple designed the X with almost no bezel, something other phone makers have already done. The X also has Apple's largest display yet at 5.8 inches. It's the same size as the Galaxy S8 and smaller than the S8 Plus and the Note 8. With the new iPhone X comes a new set of swipes and button presses you'll have to learn. That's because there's no physical home button. Here are a few examples of what's new. To wake up the X, you can tap the display or raise the device towards you or press the side button. To get back to the home screen, swipe up from the bottom edge of the display. To slide through apps, swipe the gesture bar at the bottom of the screen to the left or right. To take a screenshot, press volume up and the side button together quickly. To turn it off, hold down the same two buttons for a few seconds or use the new shutdown option in Settings, General. Our testers say it takes some getting used to, but the new swipes and presses work well. There's been a lot of talk about the new look of the iPhone X, specifically the notch. Some apps are optimized for it, some aren't. For example, in the YouTube app, you can choose between watching a smaller video in a letterbox or having some of your video cut off by the notch. Apple's new Face ID feature uses facial recognition technology to unlock your phone, replacing Touch ID, which uses your fingerprint. We tried Face ID on three subjects with different skin tones under different lighting conditions. The only time we had an issue is when a subject wore a baseball cap low, blocking a portion of their forehead and casting a shadow on part of their face. Also, our testers found you must hold the phone in front of your face, not too far to either side. As a backup, there's always a 6-digit passcode you can enter on the screen if you have issues with Face ID, so you shouldn't ever be locked out of your phone. For the first time on an iPhone, the X features a high-quality Oled screen, something we've already seen from companies like Samsung and LG. We had our TV experts take a look at a few phones and an OLED TV we use for reference in our lab. Because it's an OLED screen, the iPhone X had deeper blacks than the iPhone 8. Compared to the other phones in our test, the X was brighter, which made colors pop, and the bright highlights made the images look more detailed. Because of that and other display test results, our initial impression is that the iPhone X doesn't have a perfect display, but it's pretty close. In our drop test, the mostly glass iPhone X suffered only a few minor scrapes after drops at different angles onto concrete from 5 feet. To check the durability of the Face ID system, we dropped the X 5 times on its top edge onto concrete from 3 feet. Face ID continued to work. We'll be doing more durability testing, including our tumble test and water immersion test, and all our test results will be available soon.